the pace at which our lives are changing, it's really affecting all of us at all levels. Psychological level, emotional level, physical level. We find that there's a lot of increase in the diseases and problems related to metabolism. It is because of the internal disturbances which are taking place in the thinking process, in the nervous system, in the body itself. And if we just compare the figures of patients visiting some major hospital over the years, say we take case of yesterday, day before yesterday, how many patients visited, and say 20 years back or 15 years back, how many patients visited and what were the reasons, you will find a drastic change in the reasons for visiting hospitals or reasons for getting admitted, the causes. We'll find that psychosomatic diseases are at increase, depression, mental disorders resulting into the physical problems, and almost all, you know, areas of our body, our personality are getting affected because of the rapid change, hurry-worry life, stresses of the life. One of the major areas which is getting affected is neuromuscular system as well as the musculoskeletal system. So today our topic is yoga for back pain, which is related to musculoskeletal problems or musculoskeletal system. So there also we find lots of problems are arising because of the stress related issues, tensions and worries which are there in our life. And it's common that the stress results into the cervical problems, or it results into lower back pain. Now if you look at the medical reasons or medical conditions. Now before proceeding further, I would like to tell you that I am not a medical professional. Some little bit of information I have gathered in my journey towards understanding human body and human mind little better through the processes of yoga. So for 25 years I have been associated with this field of yoga, and while teaching and learning yoga, some information has been gathered, that much I will be sharing with you. And professionally I'm not a medical person, so medical information I may not be able to give you perfect and accurate. But still, whatever I know, I'll try to share with you. So when we are talking about back pain, normally, you see, back pain is a very, very common problem. And we don't pay attention to it unless it has become very, very severe. And what are the causes for back pain? Most of the time, we find that if the causes are in the form of injuries, in the form of some diseases, degenerative diseases, then nothing much can be done at our level. We have not much control over it. Injuries, accidents, they are just happenings and they take place. So we can't do much about it. But there is a lot we can do about certain other kinds of back problems, where the problems are because of the faulty posture, because of the stresses, because of wrong handling of the body, abuse of the body. So that's where we can do something about it. So today's session will be restricting itself to that area where we have some intervention possible or some kind of control is possible. So that area we will be talking about. And in that area we find that functional area, we find that lifestyle. This is very another very important area of our modern times. Lifestyle diseases. Lots of problems are occurring because of the lifestyle we have, the way we have our routines throughout the day. Those routines are leading us to certain physical problems. And one of the problems area is again back, because of the faulty routines, because of the lifestyle. So postural awareness, that could be one of the major area in our getting problems of the back pain. So what we have to do is, we have to do something, we have to incorporate something in our daily life which can take care of this problem area. So what do we incorporate? Very simple techniques are there of yoga which we can do, and through yoga we can definitely tackle this problem of back pain. But now we have to understand that when the severe problem of back is there, at that time no exercise, no manipulation is possible. There are also lots of misconceptions that anybody having back problem thinks by exercise he can, you know, get rid of it. Sometimes the medical intervention is necessary. The medication is necessary. So at that time it is necessary that the person has to take bed rest, has to follow the medical advice, has to consult some good doctor, and he has to take all the medicines in the form of, say, we can have anti-inflammatory drugs. Those are necessary in certain conditions, so one should not avoid them. Muscle relaxants are there, analgesics are there. To a certain extent, they are necessary when there is an acute pain or acute stage of any, you know, disorder. In the form of, say, lumbar spondylosis is there, disc prolapse is there. Now, these are conditions where medical intervention is a must. There, yoga initially cannot be of much help. So, we have to go for medication. That time, we cannot say that, you know, without medication, we can be okay. That will be a misconception. That will be a wrong notion that we can get rid of back pain without medication. So, such conditions, it is necessary that we follow certain strict routine of taking medicines and following a, you know, discipline. Now, in such a condition, what positions can be of help? Now, you see, whenever there is an acute back pain, or when, you know, you are feeling that it is affecting your day-to-day functioning, one of the basic position which in which we can do little exercise or give some relief to our body is, so whenever, you know, this kind of problem is there, initial stages what we do is we just take rest in this body position. Hands can be kept on the stomach or they can be kept at the back of the head. Now this curvature which I have made sharp, it will get automatically reduced when we are lying down in this position. So this will provide lot of relief to the back. At that time when the pain is there, one should not try any exercise at all. The only exercise he is permitted, or in only body position which could be of help and which is permitted, is this particular body position. So we just lie down. So raising the legs up, keeping them on a cushion, relaxing the back completely. For 5, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, when the pain is there, we can do this. We'll find that immediately it gives relief. Even while sleeping during the night, we can have this position where the legs are raised and hips are folded, so the back gets proper rest. Now, this is the most important position we can have. Once the pain subsides, then we can have other things. There's another position we can, when the pain is going on, we can lie down in the similar position. Only thing is, instead of keeping the legs up, we can keep them down. Both the hands we can keep on a stomach. And as we are lying down, around 20 to 30 rounds of breath, we can just observe our abdomen rising and falling as we are inhaling and exhaling. So this could be another position which can be of great help when the back pain is there. Similarly, if the cervical region, the position of the hands can be of great help, because when we are resting, it can really help the nape region or the cervical region. This is, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We can keep like that, it will provide some relief to the neck region. So this is the initial position, and once the pain starts subsiding, then we can really have lots of things possible for us in the form of strengthening the back, or, you know, resolving the pain properly, and all will be ready for doing some practices.
Yes.
Yeah. So once the pain is resolved, now we have to understand, as I told you, lot of awareness, body awareness is needed to be able to be free of these musculoskeletal problems. If we just pay attention to our body and exercise regularly in a proper way, then we can avoid all these you know, small problems, and to a great extent you know, we can escape muscle injuries by way of strong muscles. If the muscles are strong, when we are walking fast or when we are doing jerky movement, sudden movement, then our muscles will have the capacity to absorb the shock. Otherwise, if the muscle tone is less and muscles are very weak, then even small movements can create a lot of injury. So what we have to do is, for back pain, we have to have a long-term strategy. And when we have long-term strategy, then what we have to do every day, we have to incorporate some physical movements in our daily routine, which will strengthen our backs and which will really help us. Now, when we are talking about joints, what happens is, we normally think joints are separate and muscles are separate. In our body, the joints are always supported by the muscle. So if a joint is becoming weak, the muscle will always come as a support. But if the muscle also becomes weak, then the joints will not be of great help to us. So, strategy would be that not only strengthen the joints but also work on the muscles. So every day what we can do is, first of all we have to create body awareness. We have to create postural awareness. Most of the problems related to back and neck and particularly cervical region or lumbar region are because we sit incorrectly. Now I'll ask you, the way you are sitting, all of you, are you sitting correctly? So the class or the yoga begins here, that how you are sitting right now. Do you think your posture is correct? Do you think this posture is such that it is going to prevent the back pain, or it is going to help us in managing or making our back strong? So this is the first thing. So what is the body posture we should have? What kind of awareness is needed for maintaining good body posture? Now, I don't remember, I went through several schools in my childhood, and I don't remember that any teacher told me what is the correct way of sitting. I remember we used to sometimes just keep our head on the table, we'll sit in any manner, but no teacher came to us and told us this is the correct manner of sitting, this is the correct manner of holding your spine. This was not taught to us. And unfortunately, I am sure that many of you must not have been taught how to hold your spine, how to sit correctly. So, beginning with that, how to hold the spine correctly? How do we do that? How do we learn that? Now we have to learn. So, how do we learn? Now suddenly it will not come. So, every day we have to practice something. So, first practice which we can do is, sit cross-legged like this. Keep both your hands on the knees. It is called Sukhasana. And trying to keep the spine straight, neck straight, we just close our eyes and focus our mind on our breath. After some time you may find that there is some problem occurring at the back. If the back is weak, lower back may start paining. You may tend to slouch. But then we have to persist. The moment we become aware that we are doing this, we have to straighten our back. And very easy way to really release the pressure on the back or spine is when you are sitting like this, or even when you are standing like this. Just imagine that somebody is catching hold of the hair at the top of the head, and the hairs are being pulled up. So the moment you create that feeling, you will find that your spine extends and it becomes straight. So this way, how much time we have to do? We may simply begin with 3 to 4 minutes, but we can take it up to 10 minutes. So every day if we can do this, we will find that any small changes taking place in our posture, we can be aware of. And when we persist with this, after a few months of practice, you will find no matter where you are, you will tend to hold your spine in correct position. So this comes with lot of training. Otherwise, normally when we are sitting, we are not sitting correctly. So this is one method of doing it. The other method would be, when we are sitting on the chairs, often you will find we sit like this and we bend forward.